Tretinoin. If you're considering using tretinoin to improve your skin, let's say if it's to fight acne, scarring, wrinkles, photoaging, or just overall anti-aging, you may be feeling a little overwhelmed. And that's okay, because I got you covered. This video is here to reassure you that you can get the results you're looking for with tretinoin. It may take a little time, as all wonderful things do take time, but these five tips that I'm about to give you are going to really get you smooth sailing with this product and avoid a lot of mistakes down the road so that you can get the results you want. Also, I'll be sharing with you one tip at the end that I think is a game changer when using tretinoin, so definitely stay tuned to the end. If you guys are new here, this channel is all about helping you make informed decisions as well as be in the know when it comes to your health and wellness. And I'd love for you all to gently tap on that like button down below. And if you really like the content, then consider subscribing as well. Also, if you guys are on Instagram, you can follow me there too. Now, without wasting any more time, let's get straight into it. Now, before I get into the first tip, it's important to know some context. Tretinoin comes in a lotion known as the brand name Altreno. It comes in a cream, brand names Avita, Refissa, and Renova, which you see prescribed more so for wrinkles. Retin A, which we discussed here on this video, which I encourage you to watch after this one, which is also a gel. So whatever form you're using, this video will still be helpful to you. I got your back. There's also a formulation called twyneo, which is FDA approved for acne vulgaris, which combines tretinoin with benzoyl peroxide in a super unique formulation using microencapsulation, which I'll discuss later in another video, so definitely subscribe. But for now, if you're wondering which one is best, it really depends on what you're wanting to achieve, right? The gel formula usually contains denatured alcohol and is prescribed to people who are dealing with acne. The cream form contains heavy emollients such as isopropyl myristate and is better suited for anti-aging purposes. There isn't much differences besides that since they contain very similar ingredients. What you will see a difference in though is the strength. 0.25%, 0.5%, and 1%, which is the strongest. And most likely if you're starting out, you might be on that 0.25. And just because it's a lower strength does not mean it won't do the job. Now that we got that out of the way, let's move on to the first tip. Apply when you're dry. After you wash your hands and cleanse your face with a gentle cleanser, these two are my current favorites, wait for your skin to completely dry. Applying tretinoin on a wet or damp face can increase absorption and easily irritate the skin, because the whole goal is to really minimize the purge, which I'll come to in a bit. Even wait 20 minutes if you're unsure if your face is still dry. Once it's dry, then use a pea-sized amount and not a peanut, because that would not be fun. And with that pea-sized amount, which is about a fourth of a gram, go ahead and start by dotting bit by bit in different areas of the face, at least 13 touch points. So 3 on the forehead, 2 on both cheeks, 1 on each side of the nose, and 4 along the jawline and chin. You would know if you use the right amount if you see that it absorbs pretty rapidly, almost disappearing right away. Then if you're going to use a moisturizer after, wait at least 20 to 30 minutes so you don't dilute the tretinoin. Or, which brings me to my second tip, buffer with a moisturizer. Find one that is 100% free of alcohol and artificial fragrances or any other peeling ingredients. These two are my current favorites. So use the moisturizer, wait 15 minutes, then use the tretinoin. The whole point of applying the tretinoin after a moisturizer may be ideal for sensitive skin. The tretinoin can still do its thing because remember, tretinoin is a form of vitamin A, a fat-soluble vitamin, which means it can layer really well with moisturizing products. All it does is that it will just lower the volume, which may be a great solution when starting out so that your skin can acclimate to a new product slower. Which, by the way, is also a trick to minimizing purging. The third tip, don't use it daily just yet. Unless your doctor told you so, when starting, you don't have to go straight to everyday use. Start with every 48 to 72 hours because you don't want to shock your skin. Give it some time to adjust. Now, there are drawbacks to this, so avoid spacing more than 3 days because you might just be delaying the retinization process, which is needed to get the full results, which is why every 2 days might be more ideal. Then you can work your way up to daily use. Nightly use is even better, so your skin won't be interrupted by those UV rays, preferably closer to bedtime, just not too close because you don't want your pillow to absorb it unless he or she has acne too. And speaking of those UV rays, the fourth tip, which I can't stress enough, is sunscreen. These two are my current favorite sunscreens, and everything I've mentioned, all the products, will be linked down below too, so definitely check them out in the description box below. Tretinoin will make your skin more sensitive to sunlight. There's no way around it. But after a few months of tretinoin use, studies do show us that the skin gradually begins to adjust to sunlight and photosensitivity does return to normal. This is going to be huge during what's known as the purge, which I talk about throughout my other videos. You have to commit to daily sun protection. During this whole process, your skin will start getting worse before it gets better. Don't be alarmed. This is because your skin is pushing all of that gunk to the surface, which causes an increase in breakouts and acne. You might see cystic acne, whiteheads, blackheads, papules. It's important to know the difference between a purge and irritation, which I talked about in this video. But don't think of this as a bad thing. Skin purging is actually a good thing. It means the tretinoin is working and you'll soon have clear skin. It might take up to 3 months of purging, but it does go away. And for using a broad spectrum sunscreen of SPF 50 or more, all while reapplying it every 2 hours, this all helps your chances of an easier retinoid purge. And lastly, the fifth tip, not giving up too early. And I always like to refer back to this photo when you feel like giving up and it's not going anywhere, even with other aspects of life. This photo applies. Look how close he was to getting the diamonds. If he just had one or two more swings at the rock, he would have won. So if you're feeling down, even with life in general, keep pushing. This symbolizes this process that you're going through now with tretinoin. And I'm going to keep it real with you guys. For acne, the results you want can take up to 3 months, not overnight or in a month. For anti-aging, it's at least 6 months, and it shouldn't matter to you since you might choose to be on this for years as maintenance. For post-inflammatory hyperpigmentation, uneven skin tone, and sun damage, it'll take 6 months as well. And remember, that's with consistent use. If you're inconsistent, go ahead and then add in all the days that you missed in that timeline. For fine lines and wrinkles, that's at least a minimum of 1 to 2 years of consistent use. Besides for pregnancy or doctor's orders and assuming your skin isn't tolerating it, there really is no point on giving up on the product, or any product for that matter, be it vitamin C serums, azelaic acid, alpha arbutin, salicylic acid. Patience is key. And lastly, since you made it till the end, the bonus tip that I'll leave you guys with is to start to form healthy habits along with using tretinoin. There are a ton of options that are considered healthy. You probably know a lot of them, so I'll narrow it down to three. Get 7 to 8 hours of restful sleep, focus on sleep quality versus quantity, so turn out the distractions before bed. Drink plenty of water to stay hydrated, 3.7 liters for men, 2.7 for women. And lastly, minimize your stress. And this can be done in a lot of ways. Preventing acne, wrinkles, and other skin problems is a multifactorial process. It all goes hand in hand, but I know you will get there. I would love to hear your thoughts down below, and if you found this useful, share with me your feedback or share this video with others. Click the subscribe button down below if you found any value in this, and I'll see you on the next one.